You're well handsome on there.
I'm still busted.
Nah, look at him. Teeks is one of the most handsome to ever even exist on this earth. Swedish versus Persian food. Guys, I am with Tico today and we are gonna be doing another food swap. I don't think I've ever done this with you before.
No, we haven't.
Ever, but
we've been talking about it.
This was supposed to be happening for a long time. We finally decided we're gonna be doing it. Tico got a bunch of his Swedish snacks and Swedish food that he grew up with, and I got a bunch of Persian things.
All I'm saying is, okay, I don't wanna be a hater. I don't wanna like start talking too early. It's not a competition like that. But if I look over here, and if I compare it to my Swedish corner.
Yo, can you guys be quiet?
Alex has been sneezing.
Oh, never mind.
No, yeah, he's still sneezing.
Jeez, guys, Alex is sneezing.
He's sneezing. It's not really a competition like that, but all I'm saying is, and this isn't, I'm still gonna try it, but
okay.
Your side does not in no way, shape, or form look as appealing as what we got going on over
here. Bro, because first of all,
bro, are you kidding me?
You got so much sweets and like candy and
meatballs.
Stuff. I got mostly just like food items.
Caviar blue.
Guys, okay, can we just take in a second? Look at that, it looks just like him, it's insane. I'm gonna let you try. So Jarvis has tried this before.
It's obvious that I made a massive mistake.
But this is basically the Persian candy. We don't really eat like sugary candy or anything like that. It's mostly just like dried fruit and like more sour things. We got dried sour cherries.
This is your guys' candy?
Yeah, basically, yeah. Growing up, like in Iran, you'd go to like a big market and there would be people on the sides of the road selling all this super fresh, super, super fresh.
Sour cherry.
Yep. Smell it first.
I know what that is.
Do you?
Yeah. People have, it's like almost like lingonberry. That's what it smells like.
Holy shit, it's so sour. Here.
Oh, it's sour?
It's really sour.
Can I dip it in a meatball?
You can do whatever you want, honestly. It might have seeds in it, so you gotta be careful. Like, you gotta like suck the,
I'm gonna be completely honest with you, buddy. I'm not gonna eat the whole thing.
Okay. So, go for it. I'm so excited
candy,
to try
huh?
all that. This is candy, yeah. This is all candy right here.
It's hard to rock, I can't bite it.
No, you have to. You gotta like suck the stuff off of it. Don't bite it, there's seeds in it. What happened? Guys, I don't know what he's talking about. I'll have a whole handful of this stuff.
That's not for me.
It's so sour, right?
Oh, so sour, and I kept trying to bite into it. That's some seeds in there. You all know how to grow, girl. You could build a house with that seed. I couldn't break it.
Rating out of 10.
Rating out of 10, I mean.
You gotta be as honest as you want.
Considering that's in a candy category, apparently.
Okay.
That's a 2.
Wow. A 2 out of 10.
I'm sorry. I'll say we just get some meatballs.
Ooh, look
clean,
at this.
Clean, simple, easy, Swedish
clean, Swedish meatballs. Okay. So you ate this growing up?
Yeah, but not like this. My mom will cook it and make it, like put it together. There's a sauce with it.
This is it like a gravy?
Exactly.
It's gravy?
Gravy, oh my God, lingonberry. I mean, this is like we're eating a bowl of popcorn, but it's still good. Trust
I would much rather eat a bowl of this watching a movie than a bowl of popcorn.
Oh, well, these are kind of good. IKEA, right?
Yeah, these are all from IKEA. Bro.
We know what we're doing.
The Swedes do not mess around when it comes to meatballs.
Bro, we have the best.
That's a fact. These meatballs, I'm gonna give them a 7 out of 10.
7 out of 10?
That's good, that's a good
not
score.
Not bad for IKEA.
There was no sauce, you know?
No sauce, we put it in a bowl.
Yeah.
I'll have another one.
7 out of 10, I'll have one too. Next up. Here, you can hold this end.
What's this?
Flip it.
Oh, it's bread.
Look at the size of this bread, guy.
I could wrap myself up and sleep in this.
Can you try to pronounce this word?
Sanjak.
Oh, pretty close.
Sanjak.
It's sangak.
Sangak.
Sangak. So this sangak. Is a very traditional Persian bread. So in Iran, usually you wake up at like 6 in the morning and you go with your grandma to literally a hole in the wall. It could be like in between a bank and they'll have like bread ovens cooking
that's
this stuff
the
super
best,
fresh.
That's
it's amazing.
I love bread like that. I try not eat bread, but bread
no,
like
no, no. This hits
or
different.
Buying bread like that is amazing.
Hits different. Hits
yeah.
different. So I want you to try it by itself first and then I want you to dip it in this.
Oh, I know I'm gonna like that.
You think so?
Yes.
This is called Kashkaban Namjoon. It's basically eggplant mushed up with a bunch of different stuff. Super, super popular dish in Iran. And dude, my mom like eats this for days.
I feel like I had a similar like, one like that in Saudi Arabia.
I'm not gonna lie, I despise this.
Really?
Everyone in Iran loves it, but I do not like it at all.
I mean, now
it's
you're
just,
making me.
It's just not my thing.
Now you're making me question what I thought it was, but I think I like it.
All right, let's go. Just rip it off. It's good, right?
I love bread like
this. It's nice. It's like it's fluffy, but it's thin. It's not too heavy.
Do you ever put it in the oven?
Yeah, it's supposed to be hot. That's why I said you get it in the morning from an oven bakery.
With this?
Yeah. Here, let me mix this for you so you can get a bunch. Here, let me show them what this looks like quick, so you guys can see. It's a very like, it's not the most appetizing thing to look at, but
it smells good though. Wow. No, I like that.
You like that?
That's what I'm saying.
Oh my God, mom, if you're watching this, Tico likes Kashkaban Namjoon. And I can't believe it, because this is, bro, anytime my mom would make this, I would hate
it. Oh, that's good, bro. That's so good.
Really?
I swear to God, I have some
more. No way. All right, out of 10, out of 10.
This is a solid for me, especially when I know what the bread could have been like as far as hot, freshly baked. I know for a fact I love this. This is a solid like 8 and 9 out of 10.
Wow.
I feel 100%.
Let's go.
Start this off with something that I can almost put money on it.
Hold on.
You're not going to like this.
Hold on.
Yeah, this is my brother on the label, by the way.
Bro, Tico, you're on the label, bro. You're literally on the label.
My name is Caleb.
What is this? It looks like toothpaste.
This is like caviar.
Caviar?
But it's like on a tube, so you put it on a sandwich, normally with some eggs, maybe, stuff like that.
Should I put it on the bread?
You could. Look, this is a pretty cool thing too. You flip this, you stick that in, and now it's open. It was sealed.
Wait, what?
It was completely sealed before.
Okay.
And then you have that now.
Oh man. All right, let me see this. Oh guys, what is that?
It has a very distinct smell and taste.
Look how it comes out.
You know what's actually the single-handedly most disturbing thing though? When you eat this and you accidentally drink like juice or something after, oh bro, this changes your taste buds. Like juice.
Wait,
after,
it's not good?
No, bro.
You're not supposed to drink juice after this, or you're supposed to?
No, definitely don't. I mean, it's just by itself like that is trippy.
Bro, I've never had anything like that before. Is it salmon? Is it salmon?
No, it's like.
Why does it feel like that? Oh, it is fish.
Yeah, well, something like that. It's a caviar, bro.
Okay. Well,
that's a
it's still the taste, the aftertaste is, it's like a sour fish. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but it has the toothpaste like texture to it. It's really trippy. I'm gonna have to give that probably like a, oh my God, I don't want to break your heart.
No, bro, you can break. I don't eat this on the regular. It's just my brother on the label.
No disrespect to Tico's brother on the label, but I'm gonna have to give that a 1 out of 10.
That's honestly what I was expecting.
It's just it's so strong.
We have good stuff. You're not gonna break my heart, I promise. All right. Good or bad?
Very good.
Ooh, it looks like a pastry.
Oh yeah, it is.
Did your mom make this?
No. This is from a Persian store. It's called Napoloni. It's basically like a flaky pastry with cream in the middle. It is amazing, bro. I could eat this for days.
That looks bomb.
Go for it.
Just a whole?
No, just take, go for it.
No, I'll split it with you.
All right.
I'm sure you want some. Oh my God, it's like
that. No, you can't split it. You can't split it. Just take a bite. What do you think?
I know what this is.
It's good, right? they usually like eat this with like tea, like right after dinner.
Bro,
or
this
like
is
even
very
before.
Similar to a pastry in Sweden after dinner with a cup of coffee.
Yeah, like exactly. Homemade. Same type of vibe.
This reminds me of like my mom or my grandma.
It's good though, right?
Yes, bro.
Ooh, I gave two things Tico likes.
The creamy vanilla is on fire. This is a solid, another like 8, 9 out of 10.
Okay, so we're getting the numbers up there.
You could just tell, bro, there's a difference from pastries when they were made with love.
Yeah.
And like natural stuff. This is a great pastry.
Oh yeah.
That vanilla cream in the middle is insane.
I'll take that, 8 out of 10, 9 out of 10.
No, that was so good, bro.
What
if you're from Sweden, if you know, you know.
Okay.
Gifla. This is insane. This is essentially like a mini little Cinnabon.
Oh my God.
But bro, I am telling you, I can almost guarantee he's gonna give this like a 9. maybe a 10 out of 10.
Bro, Cinnabon is my favorite.
I tell you, just put it in your mouth and eat it. Like, the whole tin.
You mind if I have another?
Yeah, have the bag, bro. You're gonna want that bag. I'm gonna catch you walking around with that bag after this video.
Oh my God, bro.
They are insane. They have them in vanilla and stuff too back home.
You know what's insane to me? That it's a packaged cinnamon roll and it tastes this good. Like, it tastes like it was just brought out of the oven, bro.
All right, rating. Another one?
Guys. Rating Tico ass 10 out of 10.
Yes!
Easy 10 out of 10.
I know he loves Cinnabons too.
Bro, this is amazing.
Coming from a packaged thing like this, like the bread, like, hey, bro, they're fresh. It doesn't look like I have a lot of the good ones left.
No, there isn't that many good ones left. Are you ready for this one?
That's the one I was not looking forward to. Anything that comes from a can like that is scary.
Yeah, they're supposed to be fresh, like homemade, but I don't know how to do that. This is called dolme. They have this in a lot of different cuisines and it's different in like a bunch of them, but it's basically a stuffed grape leaf. So there's like rice in it and there's usually meat, but I
recognize that. Now, the way you explained it and now I started looking at it and read it, this stuff, did I have that in Saudi or something stuffed leaf?
No, they have it. It's a very Middle Eastern food.
I feel like I might have tried it. Is that smell gonna be like absurd?
No. What do you think?
Yeah, it just wrapped up leaves.
Yeah, so you can put really whatever, but in this one, I think it's just vegetables and rice. Bro, this stuff is my favorite.
For real?
It's so good.
For real?
You're not gonna like it though.
Oh yeah?
Mm-mm. I don't think so. See, this is why I love Tigo. He's down to try it at least. Even if he doesn't like it, he'll try it. Mmm.
I have this like weird opinion about it where I don't dislike it.
But it's not your favorite?
I could easily continue to eat it. I could chew it. I'm thinking about it. But I can't say I like it.
Yeah.
But like I have no issue.
It's mediocre.
Yeah, it's like 5 out of 10.
There we go, that's fine.
I'd eat it.
Bro, this is a very...
I feel like it's insane fresh though.
Oh yeah,
like when this is, again, when it's made there and it's not from like a can. Like,
oh
like,
yeah, when grandma makes it, it's different.
You know what's crazy, Nikon? You know how you said I like try it, everything and stuff? You know, as a kid, I was...
Total opposite.
The pickiest eater. Bro, if it was green or someone mentioned salad, like I wouldn't, like, bro, I couldn't eat anything. I was
it's crazy.
Basic little kid eater.
Because I feel
I
like
eat everything.
I feel like that's what happens though. When you're growing up, you're like a little bit picky. And then once you kind of expanding your palate is so important.
Bro.
So important. Guys, you cannot be afraid to try food.
Don't be stuck in like the fast food type. Like, there's amazing food out there if you just allow yourself to.
Because it ain't going to kill you.
I'm going to present to you some what we call Swedish pancakes. This is probably more like a crepe for you guys, most of you guys. But this is like what we call pancakes. And your guys' pancakes are like our waffles. So it's a little mixed.
Whoa, that's trippy.
Yeah, so these are all pancakes. Okay. We would get these in school every Thursday with soup.
What soup?
To me,
if it's not
very
Swedish,
American.
Okay,
no, to no, add it. No, no, you can if you
no,
want.
No, but I want it to be completely Swedish, so I'm not gonna go for it. Look at these things.
I had like, never had syrup on a piece of pancake.
Well, they're really thin.
But they don't taste like much because you need like, you know what I would do even with these?
Bro.
I will flip them open. This is how I would do as a kid. I would flip them open as a full square.
Bro.
A little bit of a piece of vanilla ice cream in the middle because they come out hot and fresh. It melts a little bit. The strawberry jam and stuff. Sometimes a little bit of Nutella or like chocolate sauce. Wrap it up and eat it. Like that's how you're supposed to eat it. But they're good.
10 out of 10. 10 out of 10.
And we have nothing. There's not even sugar. There's nothing on it. That's how good they are.
It's so, the texture, I wish you guys could taste it because it's just so good. So here we have, it's called kebab kubide. It's the most traditional Persian dish that there is. It's basically minced like beef, ground beef, put on a skewer and grilled over fire, like charcoal. With basmati rice with saffron on it. And there's no tomato, but there's supposed to be a tomato. And for all my Persians out there, you already know, we have some dur.
Yeah, this is, y'all, okay, so off camera, I sat down and I looked at this and I go, Nikon, you're tripping, or you guys are tripping. Like, I'm sorry, I'm not trying to point any fingers, but like, what are you all doing with a mint flavor yogurt soda?
And it's carbonated yogurt soda.
Huh?
This is only
one. Why?
There's two variations. This one's carbonated and this one isn't carbonated.
So you're telling me I have to try both?
You have to try both. Wait. You have to take a bite of this first and then you wash it down with that.
Okay. This I know I'm gonna love.
Oh yeah, you've had this before.
I know I'm gonna love this. Yeah. We have a lot of like...
Oh, there is a tomato in there.
We have a lot of... Yeah. We
do. It was just hiding.
We have a lot of like Middle Eastern and Mediterranean food back home too.
I wish... Sweden. Oh my God, it's so good. I wish I could just go back to Iran and... Damn, he went crazy with it.
I love this. I could eat this whole plate.
I'm telling you, I don't think I've met one person who doesn't like kubide.
This, bro, this, or some chicken.
Like, there's no chance.
I could eat this daily. So, do you drink this? Like, would you just like sit down on Friday night and snap open a yogurt soda?
Take a sip and then I'll show you what I do.
No, you're not. If you slam that, stop.
Bro, it's so fire.
You all really went to the store, bought a yogurt, put it in your soda stream and called it a soda.
Bro.
It just, what?
This meal, bro, I could eat it every day.
That's way worse.
It's worse?
Bro, it's yogurt.
Yeah, it's a yogurt drink.
You don't just, no.
That's how it goes.
No.
All right. What do we got here?
I'm gonna separate them.
Yeah,
This right here is a solid meal for me. I'd eat this daily. It's a 9 out of 10.
How about these ones? The best ones.
I just don't think yogurt should be a soda or be carbonated or considered so or drinkable. I don't think you should consume yogurt like that.
Okay, fair enough.
Maybe you should. Maybe I'm wrong. To me, these are like one out of 10, okay. 0 out of 10.
Fair enough.
Not for me.
Bro, don't worry. I've showed this drink to many, many people who have never tried it. They ain't about it.
It ain't it. These two right here are essentially the exact same, just different shapes. So we could open them both. Personally, this is like a special edition with the dime ting. But just this alone, the Marabou, like clean milk chocolate, is personally the best milk chocolate there is.
Oh, so this is like a collab.
Yes, so this is like a dual tosh, you know, collaboration.
Wow.
You'll rip a row out, you can rip a square out. But I'm sure you'll like that.
Hmm.
The dime is, again, it makes it different because the dime has like the caramel and the crunchiness.
Yeah, I think that's what's throwing me off.
But bro, the regular, just straight milk chocolate of this version is godlike.
Is that just chocolate?
No, this is, you bought both dime. So this is dime too. You can feel that milk chocolate, you know what I'm saying?
Mm.
That's how good it is before the crunchy. I mean, I love the crunchy too.
Okay.
But you see what I'm saying?
I'm gonna give this a 6 out of 10.
Okay.
That's pretty good.
Okay.
Cause I'm not the biggest chocolate fan.
That's very respectable.
Next up, we have Level Shack.
I don't even know what that is.
It's basically, again, like our candy. It's a dried fruit rolled up, super sour.
Y'all love it sour, don't you?
Oh yeah, sour.
You know what I was hoping it was actually that I feel like I would have liked when I just first looked at it? Like a sausage, like a
pepperette.
Like a big glizzy.
No, this ain't a glizzy. Smell it.
Nah.
And we have three different kinds you're gonna try. We have this one. And we have this one. Look at this thing. It looks like black licorice, but it ain't.
Yeah. Yeah.
That ain't it.
It's just not candy.
It is. This is
no,
candy.
No.
Look,
no,
ready,
no.
Bro? Mmm. It's so good.
You're different. Put some callus on it.
No callus for me. I don't like callus. Bro, this is a 10 out of 10.
I mean, this is pretty good.
Right?
But
see?
It's just the texture. I feel like everything gets stuck on my teeth.
Oh, yeah. No, that's one problem. It's a very...
It just gets stuck.
They're super sticky.
This is like... I could eat that, though.
All right.
What's a green one saying?
This is green apple. Dried green apple. Bro, I usually could sit down and eat a whole pack of these. They're all very similar.
Green apple's nice.
Mm-hmm.
Green apple's nice.
If you had to rate that section, what would it be?
The whole section as a whole?
Yeah.
I mean, if it wasn't for green apple, it would have been low. So I'm gonna say like a 3, 4 out of 10.
Okay.
You know how we were talking about the whole dime thing?
Yeah.
Well, this is its own thing. This is no collaboration. This is just Dime doing its own thing. And this is one of the more cracked out cakes that you can get.
You've had this before.
Oh, if I've had this before. Some may say I grew up on this.
Okay.
No, definitely not. That would, I would have been dead.
What is
but I've had cake? A lot of them, bro. It's an insane cake.
No way it came out like that, bro.
I'm telling you, the fact that you can buy this in a little box like this and it comes out that good, that fresh, I don't even really know how that's
bro,
a thing.
What?
Let me slice that one up, bro.
All right. What is that? What is that?
Bro, it's actually insane. And it has layers to it. This is super rich though. Like
super sweet?
Bro, no, just like rich. Like, you'll look at this and be like, oh, that's a small piece. Bro, this little small piece which will almost like fill you up. It has like layers like that.
Bro, that looks insane.
Caramel sauce and nuts and just mixes. But bro, that is a cake.
Okay, here I go.
Cake. Super rich though. You can't eat too much of it.
Bro.
It's so good.
Are you kidding me, bro?
There's a couple of different versions too, like.
Get this away from me. Get it away, because I'm going to eat the whole thing. Get it away, get it away. Bro, that is nuts. Oh my God.
Yo, I could eat this all night.
Mm. Bro, I don't even know what to say.
The top right?
Bro, the inside. Oh my God.
Yo.
Bro, 10 out of 10.
Yeah, no, this is a 10 out of 10. Like, this used to be like one of those things where like, you know, you and your boys are trying to eat something good and make it simple. You go to the grocery store, every grocery store,
has
you
this?
Buy this in the freezer.
I'm not gonna say anything else, just goodbye. I love you guys. I'm gonna go finish this cake. Peace out, phase up. Let's go.